15 for Miss Delaware, America. At this time, fans, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First, would you welcome and introduce the visiting UNCW Seahawks. Introducing first, at guard, the 5'7 freshman of Newark, New Jersey, number one, Nakaya T. At guard, the 5'8 freshman of Winter Haven, Florida, number two, Bree Oakley. At guard, the 5'9 freshman of Marietta, Georgia, number 22, Amber Reed. At forward, a 6'2 freshman of Hickory, North Carolina, number 45, Ryan Flomber. And at guard, a 5'4 junior of STEM, North Carolina, number 3, Kelva Atkins. Coaching staff for UNCW. Director of Basketball Operations, David Kim. Assistant coaches are Jason Eschbaugh, Richard Warren, Kim Tinkley. Ladies and gentlemen, our second season at UNCW, the head coach, Adele Harris.
Delaware team 17 points and 8.5 rebounds per game. In the backcourt, it's starting point guard Erica Brown, the second leading scorer at 9.5 points and 3 boards per contest. And the senior, Akima Richards, 7.5 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 steals per game. Christine, it's quite simple. Delaware has got to get a better performance than what they got last week. This is probably the perfect opponent, though, to be welcoming into the Bob, considering the circumstances.
It is, but it's also a little scary because you don't want to look past an opponent. You have Drexel on Sunday, and that's a huge rivalry. The record of this team, 1-15, you can't worry about anything right now because all Delaware needs to worry about is bouncing back from one of the worst losses in the last few years.
Very true indeed. We'll see how the Hens are able to perform this evening. Kelsey Buchanan going to tip it up for Delaware in the home white jerseys with the blue numbers, yellow trim. Meanwhile, UNC Wilmington, the teal jerseys, navy blue trim, white numbers. Kelsey Buchanan wins the tip, gets it to Akiva Richards. As Delaware operating left to right in this opening half, a trailing Erica Brown takes the pass and sets up the offense for UD. Dribbles towards the right wing, feeds to the high post to Buchanan. Out far corner, Hannah Jardine hits a deep two. Nice start for the Blueheads. Hannah Jardine from 18 feet.
And Hannah Jardine picking up right where she left off in the last few games. She's been getting a lot more minutes and earned a starting role, and that's what what they want from her. They want her to be able to shoot and feel confident doing it.
Atkins dribbling top of the circle for UNC Wilmington, dishing off right wing and trying to drive baseline inside. Bree Mobley finds some space and able to finish off the window.
And UNCW now in a full court press, as many teams have done to this Delaware squad. But again, that back line of the zone, not kind to the Hens.
2-2-1 look, and Delaware able to get it across relatively easily. Erica Brown dribbling in the forecourt for UD. 15 on the timer as she moves towards the right wing. Feeds top of the circle. Kelsey Buchanan on the right block. A bounce pass to East. Johnson couldn't finish. Got her own miss, though. Step back follow is good. Hens up 4-2. They should be able to have a lot of success on the offensive glass.
And UNCW playing behind on that shape-up by Shanice Johnson. And you're right. If they can see the numbers, they got to give it into the post.
Here's Amber Reeves operating top of the circle for Wilmington, dribbling to the foul line, now backing it out to the perimeter. Left wing dish over to Atkins, back to Reeves, right wing. Cross court feed near corner to Mobley. Mobley dribbles towards the box, kicks it out top of the circle. Atkins, Atkins over right wing to Reeves. Reeves into the corner with a bounce, three to shoot. Out to Atkins, she'll fire and hit a 25-footer straight away, and Wilmington leads 5-4.
And make no mistake, Atkins is a very good player, and she can hit that shot from that far out.
Johnson got bumped. Fed it over the top to Buchanan. She dished it off to Richards, and her pass was tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Wilmington. Hustling Mobley getting into the passing lanes, and then they'll say it was deflected off of Delaware. So they reversed the call, and it'll go back to UNC Wilmington.
She threw that off the foot of Akeem Richards. Very smart play, and Tina Martin not happy with the lack of hustle there on that possession.
Hens down a point, just under 2 minutes into the contest. Reeves with it in the forecourt for Wilmington. Feeding up top to Teague, lob it. Far corner to Reeves. Reeves on the left block inside of Flowers. Turn and face. Cross-court dish. Left wing Mobley. Mobley into the corner near side Atkins. Crossover dribble move got by Johnson. Dished it off to Mobley and misses a 15-footer badly. Rebound, though. Flowers was fouled as she put it back up. Kelsey Buchanan went for the block, got a lot of ball for a small piece of arm.
And that's been an issue for this young Hens squad. They have not been able to stop dribble penetration. And keep in mind, this coaching staff includes Kim Tingley, a former player in this program. She knows the ins and the outs of the zone and how to attack it.
That's a good point. It'll be interesting to see what Delaware does defensively as Flowers misses the first free throw badly. Because of the lack of Green, the lack of Sawyer, they don't have a lot of depth in the backcourt. Peter Martin saying they might have to go to a straight 2-3 as Flowers knocks in the second foul shot.
And I don't know if this team really knows how to play a straight 2-3 because they never have. There are so many intricacies in this zone.
Johnson drops the ball in the backcourt. It's taken away by Wilmington. And then a foul on the reach by Shanice Johnson. The steal from Bree Mobley, but that was more of an unforced error there for Delaware.
And UNC Wilmington right now looking like the aggressors. They are out-hustling this Hens squad.
They gave the foul to Akeema Richards, who was 60 feet away from the play. But that's who it goes on. It's her first, team second, near corner, deep jumper, missed by Amber Reeves. And the long rebound, though, grabbed by Teague. Teague, cross court, deep on the right elbow. Jumper good for Bree Mobley. And it is an 8-4 UNC Wilmington edge.
And have you noticed where those shots are coming from? The short corner, the high post. They're picking the spots, the sweet spots against this zone.
They're throwing it right over the top, too. Well moved by UNC Wilmington, who has struggled offensively in the early going. Here's an entry feed on the right block to Buchanan. Looks opposite, deep two. Hannah Jardine missed it, didn't follow her shot. It came right back to her, but she wasn't there anymore. Rebound Reeves. Reeves racing into the forecourt. Dishes it off on the baseline. Teague tried a reverse layup. Couldn't get it to go, but got contacted on the way up. And as a result, she'll head to the stripe for two more. Ugly start here for Delaware in the first three-plus minutes.
And they're just being outplayed, not basketball-wise and basketball one-on-one, but hustle-wise, UNC Wilmington getting to every loose ball, attacking and dribble penetrating.
They gave that foul to Shanice Johnson as the first free throw is good for Teague. It was a big break there for Delaware that previous foul got called on Richards. I am 100% positive that should have been Shanice Johnson's foul. The good news continues for Delaware as Courtney Green is going to come into the game. Shanice Johnson will check out, as will Akeema Richards, also in Alicia Bell, the second free throw good as well. So Teague knocks down a pair. The lead is 6 for Wilmington in the early going.
And with the lack of bodies for this Delaware squad, they really cannot afford to have anyone in that back line get into foul trouble.
Hannah Jardine almost walking in the backcourt. She dragged her pivot ever so slightly. No call, though. They move it into the forecourt. Erica Brown dribbling between the rings. Left wing bounce. Pass goes to Alicia Bell. Up top to Hannah Jardine. One dribble. Now feeds right wing to Green. Green into the corner to Brown. Left-hand bounce with 8 on the timer. High screen comes from Jardine. She uses it. Peels towards the foul line. Now entry feed, left block. Buchanan, turnaround jumper wouldn't go. Offensive rebound, Jardine. Spinning layup attempt is too strong. Rebounds loose on the floor. Scrum for it. Buchanan hustling after it. Forced the tie-up amongst 4 Seahawks. Good news is good hustle by Buchanan. Bad news is where were all of her teammates? It was 1-on-4. Arrow belongs to UNC Wilmington.
Like that early shape-up that Shanice Johnson had, and she was able to seal her player. Kelsey Buchanan was holding that shape-up. She had her player sealed. They have to give her the basketball, and you have to give it to her on a bounce pass where she can then attack and make her move.
Hens try a trap here. UNC Wilmington brings it across, but Amber Reed is able to dribble out of it. Feeds in front of the Delaware bench on the right wing to Mobley. Mobley gives it off. Left baseline to Teague. Sure, jump shot strong. Offensive board grabbed there by Flowers. They reset the shot clock. I thought accurately, it looked to me as though the ball hit the rim. That'll take us to a media timeout. We'll see where they put the clock when we come back. 15:58 left to go in the opening half. UNC Wilmington 10, Delaware 4. This is Blue Hens basketball on 12 Night of the Ticket at 1410 WDOV. Top, they reset the shot clock. Accurately so, the official thought it had not hit the rim. That's why we went to break. But it's UNC Wilmington ball out of the media timeout. Had a walk here called on Wilmington. Head fake by Amber Reeves, and she was a little too anxious to try to drive by the rotating Delaware defense. She dragged her pivot foot before putting it on the deck.
And one thing we talked a lot about pregame was rebounding, and Delaware needs to out-rebound this team, and they're already getting, you know, doubled up on the boards, 5-2.
Kelsey Buchanan stripped it midcourt, lost it off her leg. Out of bounds to UNC Wilmington. A sloppy start here for the Hens, and honestly, they're picking up right where they left off down in Harrisonburg.
And you know what, Matt? Sometimes when negative things are happening and it's a down, you need just a couple of things to go right, and then you kind of snap out of it, and that's really what Delaware needs right now.
Teague, top of the circle with it for Wilmington. The good news is UNCW doesn't go all that deep, so the Hens have to hope maybe they can wear Wilmington down. Atkins gets it near quarter, feeds left wing to Mobley. Mobley up top to Teague. Teague fires on the right wing, a pass to Atkins. Her shot wouldn't go. Rebound, a tie-up. Brown Antique fighting for the ball, and the possession arrow belongs to Delaware. So it'll be Hens basketball. Joy Caracciolo going to come into the game for the first time for UD. She'll replace Hannah Jardine.
And if you're going to wear UNCW down, you have to attack on the offensive end. You have to draw fouls. You have to penetrate those seams. And Delaware right now sloppy with the ball and not doing the little things that you need to do against this defense.
Brown and Green catching the backcourt to get it across the timeline. 18 on the timer as Delaware sets up its offense. Brown top of the circle, right wing dish over to Green. Green, high post feed to Caracciolo. Three hard dribbles with a left hand towards the block. Now kicks it out far corner to Bell, trying to give it back to Caracciolo. It was tipped away and stolen. Here comes Mobley in the open floor, lobs it forward to Atkins with a left hand finish. Pretty break there from Wilmington, and they lead it 12-4.
Just playing harder. They are flat out just playing harder right now and not as sloppy as Delaware.
Brown floats it to center court to Courtney Green. Back to Brown, trailing the play to set things up. Wilmington taking 10 seconds out of each possession with that full court pressure. On the right wing, it's Brown. Right hand dribble looking for some help. Caracciolo shaping up. They don't give it to her. Instead, up top to Green, and a hand check foul. Going to be called on Bree Mobley for UNC Wilmington. She got a little too over-aggressive that time. Jade Clark going to come into the game for the Hens. Out goes Alicia Bell. Meanwhile, into the contest comes De'Asia Kane for Wilmington. Nakia Teague will take a seat.
Delaware with a big size advantage on that back line, and they are shaping up and they are holding the seal, but the guards must deliver the basketball.
Johanna McMillan also into the contest for Wilmington. Inbound goes to Brown, left wing triple, in and out, weak side rebound. Caracciolo tipped it, but Mobley ends up with it under the basket for Wilmington, and she'll bring it up for the seal. Left wing dish to Kane. Kane into the corner to Atkins. Tried to drive baseline. Dished it off to Kane. Top of the circle. She'll leave it off to Mobley, who resets. Mobley left hand dribble towards the wing. 12 on the timer. Feeds between the circles to Kane. Kane right hand bounce. Chest pass over to Atkins. Atkins up top to Mobley. Mobley off the bounce. Pulls up. Left wing jumper wouldn't go. Nice rebound in traffic by Buchanan. Outlets it forward to Brown. Looking to push. Nothing there for Erica. Feeds right wing wide open. Trailing the play. Courtney Green triple. Back rimmed it. Offensive board though. Caracciolo turnaround shot. Wouldn't go, but she was fouled. And finally some work on the offensive glass from Delaware. An area the Hens should be able to have some success tonight.
They absolutely should. And it's all about being in the right position and pushing back. But a really good sign for the Hens. No hesitation at all from Courtney Green. Again, she had surgery this week, not feeling 100%. We weren't even sure she was going to play in this basketball game, so a really good sign that she lit it up as soon as she was able to release the basketball.
Caracciolo knocking down the first free throw. Courtney Green's going to check out. Akima Richards is going to come back in. It's been a tough go for Courtney Green with this broken nose. She had it set, but still having some pain that she's dealing with.
And you can look at her body language right now as she slowly walked down the bench, slapping five to everybody. You can tell she is not feeling very well.
Second free throw, Caracciolo can't connect. She missed a pair. Rebound, though, Jake Clark hustled it down, but then threw it away. McMillan on the steal. Outlets it forward to Atkins. No numbers. She'll find a trailing Reeves. Reeves back to Atkins, who will set it up. So the Hens down 7, 12-5, 13-15 left first half. Right wing dish goes over to McMillan. McMillan circles towards the top of the key with a left-hand bounce. Right wing dish over to Atkins. Crossover move on Richards. Can't go anywhere. Dishes off to Kane. Baseline long two is good. Timeout, Tina Martin, 14-5. Wilmington all over Delaware. Just over 7 minutes into this contest. Seahawks sharper on offense and quicker to loose balls.
I'll tell you what, I have to tell you, I'm very impressed with UNCW's patience. They're being very patient on offense, and they know what they're looking for. Those short corners, the penetration, the high post. It's almost like they know exactly how to attack the zone. Again, you know, they have a UD alumni on their coaching staff, so she knows the zone too, but I'm just really surprised right now at the lack of response and bouncing back by this Delaware team.
Delaware women's basketball being brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units, which have been servicing the local community for over 20 years. For non-life-threatening injuries, go to Glasgow Medical Aid Units with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Visit them online at glasgowmedicalcenter.com. So out of the Delaware called timeout, it's Hens basketball. Erica Brown dribbling in the backcourt. Some full-court pressure here for Wilmington. Again, token pressure that just burns clock. Hens take 10 seconds to get it across. Richards dribbling top of the circle, finds Brown trailing the play to finally set things up with 15 on the shot clock. High post entry to Buchanan. Quick jumper, deep two, wouldn't go. She back-rimmed it. High rebound grab by McMillan. And here comes Wilmington the other way. Long outlet to Teague. Teague lost it, ran it down in the corner. Found Atkins left wing. She'll drive, get by Brown, and Brown forced a Fowler on the way to the 10 as a result. Erica Brown called for her first foul. It's the team's fourth with 12:26 left first half, and Delaware down 14-5.
And the more UNCW takes time off that clock when they're on defense and causing Delaware to use more of the shot clock, it's going to limit possessions for the Hens.
Reeves to throw it in baseline right, lobs it between the rings to Teague. Teague dishes it off right side to Atkins. Atkins brings it out back near center court. Now dribbles over towards the left wing. Feeds top of the circle, McMillan. High screen comes from Kane. She uses it. Now picks up her bounce. Feeds in the corner to Atkins. Atkins spinning on Caracciolo. Dishes up top to Reeves. Around the perimeter. Extra feed into the corner. McMillan. Deep three. Wouldn't go. Rebound. Batted around. Chased down by Wilmington. It didn't hit the rim, though. Five left on the timer. Atkins doesn't see it. Two left. She dribbles out near center court. Heaves one up. It wouldn't go, but another offensive rebound. Corralled by Teague. Teague dishes it off. Inside McMillan. McMillan is fouled on her way up. Actually, she dished it off last second, and it's Reeves who had the quick release and got fouled at. We'll shoot two free throws when we come back. Are you kidding me? Three offensive rebounds on that possession by the smaller Seahawks, who lead Delaware by nine. 11:48 left to go in the first half. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
Enjoy Blue Hens basketball this season at the Bob with ticket specials, including youth group packages. The Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball, game packs, and CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action at the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
To a slow first half to start this game against UNC Wilmington. 11:48 left to go in the opening half. UNCW 14, Delaware 5. At the free throw line, out of the media timeout, Amber Reeves to two shots here for Wilmington. Her first free throw is good, and the Hens have a double-digit deficit against a 1-15 team. A shocking start here at the Bob.
And they're being out-rebounded 10-5, doubled up on the rebound against a smaller and not as aggressive team.
Reeves knocks down a pair. A surprising start, to say the least. The pressure has bothered Delaware in the early going, and they face it again. Lob pass into the center of the floor to Richards from Erica Brown. Richards races it towards the top of the key, then hits a trailing Brown. So at least Delaware will get a full 22 seconds to operate their offense here. Brown dribbling towards the right wing, feeding up top, Shanice Johnson. Left wing bounce pass over to Richards. Richards to Brown on the right wing for three. Right rim, no good. Rebound tipped by Jay Clark, out of bounds off of her hands. And it'll go back to Wilmington. Another one-and-done possession for UD.
And very interesting, Adele Harris deciding to go to a 2-3 zone there. The man-to-man had been working very well, but she mixed things up and she confused Delaware a little bit.
Hence, making a change, Erica Brown will sit down. Courtney Green comes back in. Did not look like the coaching staff loved that shot from Brown. UNCW with the ball. Mobley dribbling into the forecourt, leaving it off to Teague. Teague dishing far side of the floor, McMillan. McMillan into the corner to Reeves, back to McMillan. Up top to Teague. Around the perimeter, left wing, Mobley. Mobley dishes up top, Teague. Holding here with 11 on the timer. Directing traffic, feeds it right wing, McMillan. McMillan with 8 to shoot. Up top to Teague. Hand off to Mobley. Mobley attacking off the bounce. Split the top of the zone. Missed the runner. And a rebound grabbed in traffic by Johnson. Nice job for Delaware, who outlets it up to Richards.
Now, if you're Delaware, you want a really solid offensive possession. You want to be patient and penetrate those seams.
Richards up top to Green. Green back to Richards on the right wing. Richards spinning her way towards the basket, floating up a 13-footer off balance, would not go. Front rimmed it, Teague the rebound.
credit to UNCW, one and done every time down for Delaware. They are getting in position, they are pushing back, and they are going after the basketball.
And everything is a tough, contested shot. Mm-hmm. Far corner, McMillan, entry feed to Flowers on the right block, dishes up top to Reeves, Reeves left wing to Teague, Teague had it stripped. Good hands, Akima Richards with the steal. Here she comes the other way, racing it into the forecourt. Top of the circle, hesitation, right wing to Clark, feeds to Johnson, back to Clark. Left hand dribble towards the foul line, off balance, ugly runner, missed the rim. Rebound grabbed by Wilmington, Flowers outlets it to Reeves who will bring it up.
Something about this UNCW defense, even last year in the CAA tournament, Delaware could not score. Delaware only has 5 points, and we've played almost 11 minutes.
Halfway through the opening half. High post entry feed to Flowers. She's doubled, spins away from it. It was tipped away by Richards, but chased down by Teague. Seven to shoot as she gives it off to Mobley. Mobley dribbling towards the right wing. Two on the timer, working on Green, spinning, forcing it up, in and out. Rebound Richards. Nice box out by Shanice Johnson to allow Richards to that ball. Richards brings it the other way, angling into the lane, scoops it up, and gets the wall, plus a foul. Hens needed that in the worst way. Akima Richards goes coast to coast, changing direction multiple times, and gets an and-one opportunity.
How fortunate that that bounced in. That was one of those, no, yes, by the coaching staff. Not the best shot, but hey, it fell, and that's all they need right now is something to go in.
Hens had six on the floor there for a moment. Now they pull Jade Clark off. As Buchanan returns, as does Hannah Jardine, also taking a seat was Caracciolo. Free throw no good. Buchanan grabbed the offensive board and went straight back up with it and was fouled on the way up. And Kelsey Buchanan will head to the line to shoot two. And this is where Delaware can get back into the game. They're bigger than Wilmington at almost every position across the board.
And basketball's an amazing game like that. A couple things start going your way and all of the momentum shifts in the other direction.
First free throw good for Buchanan. Pretty good sized crowd here at the Carpenter Center tonight. Pep Band is back, trying to be involved. They've been pretty quiet in the early going thanks to Wilmington's solid play. Buchanan knocking down a pair, though. No surprise there. She's an 85% free throw shooter, and the deficit down to seven.
You see a little bit of pep in the step now of this defense. They're a little bit on their toes, a lot more active already.
Top of the circle with the bounce is Kane. Kane hands it off on a weave play to Teague. Teague dishes left wing to a wide open Reeves. Back to Teague. Around the perimeter, right side to Kane. Kane, far corner feed to McMillan. Up top to Kane, over to Mobley. Seven to shoot, everything around the perimeter right now. Five on the timer, leaves it to Reeves. Reeves left wing McMillan. On the baseline, Teague. One on the timer, she's not going to get a shot off. Ball is loose, and finally, 3 seconds later, they blow the whistle for a shot clock violation. Nobody had possession, and the buzzer had sounded.
Much better rotation there in the back line by the three post players, and they were guarding that short corner where they almost trapped it and forced the bad pass.
Wilmington seems like they've gone to the Dean Smith four corners offense. I'm not sure what they're doing right now. Entry feed on the left block, Buchanan turn and face, and she'll bang home about an eighth footer. Nice touch by the senior.
And Kelsey Buchanan has that look all night. She's taller than everybody else. She releases her shot very high on the top of her head, and she can get that look.
See, if Wilmington tries to execute something offensively, Delaware's defense has played better, but UNCW has helped them by being very passive. Mobley around the perimeter, right wing to Teague. Again, everything is around the arc. Up top to Mobley. Mobley got away with a huge walk. Now spins her way towards the lane, but is stripped by Richards. Richards to her backside with the ball. And finally, they call a tie-up. And possession arrow will give it back to Wilmington. Crowd did not like that. Thought there was a walk and then a foul. Certainly there was a walk. I thought it was good hustle from there.
Yeah, Kima Richards should have gotten her second steal of the game on that. And the way they closed down, and she was trying to call timeout. But, rough break there.
I don't think she had full control of the ball when she called timeout. Do you?
Earlier she did. I think she did earlier.
Inbound pass goes far corner to Mobley. Mobley will circle it towards the top. 8 minutes left first half. Hens down by five, 16-11. Wilmington with the ball. Atkins left wing with it. Feeds right wing to Reeves. Reeves left hand dribble towards the top off a high screen to the foul line. Gives it to Atkins left wing. Up top, back to Reeves. Again, around the perimeter, right wing, dish to Kane. Back to Reeves, left wing to Atkins. Deep triple, wouldn't go, right rim. Rebound tipped by Johnson into the breadbasket of Jardine. Outlets it to Richards. Richards looking to run, hesitation move towards the basket. Scooped it up a little too strong, but she was fouled again. Akiva Richards drawing whistles. The Hens more active defensively. This is more like it from Delaware. We'll take a timeout. 7:30 left in the opening half. Wilmington still up by just 5 now, though. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket at 1410 WDOB.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
The best in hotel accommodations and amenities, the Embassy Suites is located across the street from the Bob Carpenter Center. To book your next hotel stay in Newark, call 302-368-8000 or check them out at newark.embassysuites.com. 7 minutes, 30 seconds left to go in the opening half. UNC Wilmington 16, Delaware 11. That sounds ugly. Honestly, it was over the first 10 and a half minutes. Delaware has played much better, though, over the last 2 minutes of action.
A little bit of a spark. And why is that? Because they're attacking the basket, being led by Akiva Richards, driving to the basket. Kelsey Buchanan shaping up, turning around, stepping back, going back to the things that they do well.
So line right, it's Akiva Richards to shoot two, and she'll rattle home the first. Richards to get one more, and she's improved steadily as the season has gone on from the stripe. Started very slow, but now all the way up to 77% for the stripe for the year, and she hits the second, and a lead down to 3 for Wilmington.
Yeah, and Akiva Richards, a player that's been moved around a lot due to injury and people not playing, so you'd like to see her play her natural position.
Here's Amber Reeves, dribbling left wing. Courtney Green harassing her, circling towards the top, now dishing off to Atkins, foul line left. Cross-court dish, right wing to Reeves. Reeves trying to attack, nothing there. Instead, dishing up to Atkins. Back to Reeves, 6 on the timer. Nice high post flash, wide open Kane, but missed the 15-footer. It's batted around and finally controlled by Jardine for Delaware.
Good that she missed that shot, but concerning that she was able to get the basketball so freely at that spot.
She made a good cut, but somebody's got to be in that vicinity defensively. Richards, right wing, looking for some help. Feeds up top to Johnson in a silly foul. Reach-in going to be called on Amber Reeves. And that is the 16th foul on UNC Wilmington, the first on Reeves.
And on that defensive possession, the back player has to ride her up and pass her off to that guard, the guard tandem.
6 3/4 minutes left in the opening half, 16-13, the UNCW lead. Richards dribbles towards the Seahawk bench, now feeds right wing to Jardine, into the corner Buchanan, cross-court dish back to Richards, deep two, wouldn't go, offensive board, weak side grab by Buchanan, her follow too strong, rebounds loose on the floor, and finally UNCW has it, outlets it up to Mobley, Mobley racing it the other way, feeds to Reeves, who walked on a head fake drive attempt.
I like what Shanice Johnson tried to do on that offensive possession. She didn't have the ball, but she pretended to shoot, hoping to draw a foul call. That was pretty intelligent there for the young freshman.
Creative, at least. And it ends up working out as her teammates got a second to run back. Now a nice press break by Delaware. Wide open left wing three. Courtney Green couldn't hit. And Mobley grabs the board for UNCW.
And Courtney Green has a green light, just like her name. Anytime she has an open three, they want her to take it.
Nice drive by Mobley. Got into the painted area, but could not finish. And then an over-the-back foul caught on UNC Wilmington. And we will walk the length. Free throws coming for Delaware as DeAsia Kane caught for going over the back. It's her first, team 7. And it's going to send Shanice Johnson, the true freshman, to the line for a 1-1.
And Delaware, as a team, has kind of been up and down this season at the free throw line. Some games they've, you know, shot it well. In other games, it's really been a crucial miss. They're shooting 68% as a team.
Johnson, though, able to knock down the first free throw. She's below that number, just 64% on the year. Johnson will get one more foul shot thanks to the first make, and she back-rimmed that one. Jardine almost got the rebound, but it's chased down by Ryan Flowers on the long board.
And those are the points you have to take advantage of. You have to make those free throws.
But Delaware's crawled back to within two. It's a 9-0 run, which seems like it's lasted a half hour. In reality, it's been about 4 minutes. Driving baseline, forcing one up. Mobley, it wouldn't go. Johnson grabs the rebound in traffic for Delaware. Outlets it to Richards. Again, looking to run. Crossover move at the foul line. Angles towards the corner and is fouled from behind by Mobley. Freshman mistake there by UNC Wilmington.
UNCW just having some mental lapses here, giving Delaware opportunities that they should not have.
Critical foul there. That is Mobley's third. Here's why it is important. Wilmington only plays seven players. They cannot, they literally cannot afford foul trouble.
And they really are one of those teams. I mean, if they do have foul trouble, they will end up with four players.
I mean, they have eight active players. That's all they have. You are right about that. As Richards knocking down the first free throw, so she'll get one more, an opportunity to tie this game. As Delaware slowly but surely has fought their way back.
And that's a mental thing. If they could tie this game or maybe take the lead, that's one of those mental, okay, here we go, now we got it. And as Akima Richards makes that second free throw.
16 apiece, 5:33 left in the first half. Here comes Wilmington into the forecourt. Reeves on the right wing, circling towards the top. Left wing dish over to McMillan. McMillan dribbles top of the circle, now feeds right wing to Reeves. Reeves off a high screen, back between the rings with her bounce. Dishes over to De'Asia Kane. Kane back to Reeves. Left wing McMillan trying to drive baseline on Johnson. Stripped her, lost it. Out of bounds, though, off of the Hens. So it'll stay with UNCW with three to shoot.
But what Shanice Johnson did very well there was she turned her hips, she cross-overstepped, and beat her to the spot. And that's why she was able to impede her progress.
Inbound will come baseline right. It'll be Reeves to trigger it. Reeves looking for Atkins. She's taken away by Richards. They feed up top to Teague. Has to fire a high arcing three. Almost banked it in. But it's in and out. Rebound Jardine for Delaware.
Now Delaware with an opportunity to take their first lead in a very long time.
Here comes Richards into the forecourt. Handoff to Courtney Green. Back to Richards, who will circle towards the top. 4:52 left first half, 16 apiece. Jardine gets it inside. Left block. Buchanan goes to work. Scoops it up and in. And the Hens have fought back a 13-0 run to take an 18-16 edge.
And that's how Delaware opened the game. They opened the game with a wing pass to a shape-up. Kelsey Buchanan has that look all game.
4-2 was Delaware's last edge. Reeves left wing for Wilmington. Dribbling to the top. Right wing over to McMillan. McMillan left-hand dribble. Looking for help, bounce pass left wing to Reeves. Again, everything's around the perimeter. Right wing to Atkins. Atkins will try to drive, turn back by Jardine. Step back jumper for the baseline, wouldn't go. Weak side rebound, a tie-up. Green and Reeves. Arrow will give it back to Delaware. And how about Courtney Green with that broken nose, sticking her face right into the fire.
Honestly, looking at her, like, she almost looks like she's going to pass out there. I mean, her body language, boy, is she very courageous here today, trying to play, having nose surgery, having it reset. I mean, she just looks exhausted.
Did you ever break your nose?
No.
Fortunately so. Very difficult to breathe. Here's a turnover. Shanice Johnson threw it away, but then took it back. Stripped it from Reeves. Gives it to Brown in the forecourt, and the point guard makes a good decision to set things up. Feeds top of the circle. Richards attacking off the dribble. Left elbow jumper. Back rim to Johnson. Tipped the rebound. It's loose. And it's run down by Atkins, who stepped on the baseline. And that'll give it back to Delaware. Momentum belongs to the Hens. It's an elongated 13-0 run. It's Delaware 18, UNC Wilmington 16. Timeout on the floor. 3:52 left to go in the first half. This is Blue Hens women's basketball on 12th night of the ticket and 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
back to the Carpenter Center in Newark. It has been an ugly shooting first half for both teams. They have combined for 10 field goals in just over 16 minutes of action. The Hens 5 of 19 from the floor, 0 of 3 from deep. Wilmington even worse, 5 of 20 from the field, 1 of 5 from three-point range. The Hens got off to the slow start. Delaware has fought back, though, to take a two-point edge.
Yeah, if you're Tina Martin in that last timeout, you're forgetting about the first 16 minutes. Let's worry about the last four and finish the half well.
3:43 and ticking. Delaware with the ball in the forecourt. Top of the circle. Johnson feeds a cutting Brown, who barrels into a Wilmington defender and is called for the charge. Way to give up the body there by Amber Reeves, the true freshman out of Marietta, Georgia.
And that's just something the young freshman, Erica Brown, who that was her second foul, she's just going to have to learn and play through that. She has a lot of offensive charges this year, and it's just learning how to kind of pull up. And it doesn't change your game, but even if you drop your shoulder at all, an older player will be able to take that charge.
Good news is I think Jody Sire is going to return for Delaware's next game, hopefully on Sunday. Definitely back for the one after that, from that concussion that she's been dealing with for a couple of weeks now. Here's Wilmington driving. Left wing jumper would not go as Kane forced it up. Rebound Delaware. Here comes Richards the other way. She's done a good job forcing tempo. Feeds left wing Jardine back up to a trailing Richards. High post to Johnson. Turn and face. Head fake. Right wing feed to Green. Did not pull the trigger. Instead feeds right elbow to Buchanan. Two hard dribbles. Pulls up and banks one home. About an 11-footer. Good touch from KB.
And good job by Shanice Johnson. She was holding her shape up, but then moved out of Kelsey's way and almost boxed her player out. Created space for Kelsey Buchanan.
20-16. Almost like a lead blocker there.
Mm-hmm.
Hens by four, Wilmington with the ball. Left wing with it, De'Asia Kane. Right hand dribble towards the top, dishes off to Atkins. Back to Kane, this time on the left wing. Kane looking high post, couldn't get it there. Feeds off near corner McMillan. McMillan circles towards the top. Dishing to Reeves. Reeves with two to shoot, forces one up, front rims it. Rebound Green. Here comes Courtney the other way. It's a 4-on-2 to Richards. Lob over the top, Jardine left hand finish. What a break by Delaware, and a lead by 6. Timeout Wilmington, a 17-0 run by UD, and Delaware has awoken.
And Akima Richards able to hit Hannah Jardine because not only did she hustle down the floor, she rode the lane wide. Anytime you're in transition, when you're filling in those lanes, you have to fill them in wide so you can get that angle. So number one, your teammate can see you, but then you create space, and she creates a very easy layup for herself.
How about a 4-on-2 with three bigs running the floor? You have to love that hustle.
Well, they know better. They know, because if they see that on film and they're not running that lane, they're going to have to deal with it in practice tomorrow.
Take us inside this week for Delaware. You've been there after getting blown out, maybe not giving up 60 in the second half, but with Tina Martin as your head coach, that could not have been the most fun week for these players.
No, definitely. And the film session was horrible. You know, you're cringing everything you're seeing. But for this coaching staff, a very fine line of building up, but then also pointing out things that you need to improve.
And they've walked it well all season long. And this team has responded here over the last 7 minutes or so. Hens by 6. Wilmington ball out of their called timeout. With it, right wing Teague. Teague dishes off McMillan. Back up top to Teague. Dribbling to the foul line. Leaves it for Kane. Kane finds McMillan. Straight away triple. No good. Rebound. Johnson went over her own teammate's back. Tipped it into the hands of Atkins. And Atkins is fouled on her way up, and we'll head to the stripe to shoot two. Friendly fire there, costing Delaware a second chance opportunity.
Tough break. Kelsey Buchanan had the inside position. She boxed her player out. Shanice Johnson tipped it, and unfortunately tipped it to Atkins, who very intelligently went up to draw that foul.
1:54 left in this first half. First free throw is good for Atkins. Atkins a leading scorer. First team preseason All-CAA selection. 15.5 points, 5 boards per game. She averages 37 minutes per contest. 70% free throw shooter, knocks down a pair. Wilmington finally off the extended schneid.
Plays a lot like an Allen Iverson. Similar body type, very thin, obviously not at that level, but the way she can maneuver and get in there, and you don't think looking at her size or her frame that she can do some of the things she can do.
Boy, you're just throwing around Allen Iverson's name in these parts. I like Atkins. I don't know if I like her quite that much.
Well,
I hear what you're saying, though. Richards, cross-court feed, left wing Green, passed up a triple, instead drives baseline all the way to the chin and finishes with the left hand. What a take by Courtney Green.
And that's something she's been able to add to her collegiate game. It was always there in high school, but being able to drive to the basket a little bit more this year.
Here's Kane, right wing McMillan, fire up another triple, missed it badly. Rebound tip by Johnson, fighting for it with Teague, and it's run down by Wilmington. Good hustle by both players. Here's Atkins, top of the circle. Jab, step, dribble, couldn't get anything going. Dishes off to Reeves. Reeves, cross-court McMillan, back to Reeves. In the corner to Teague, spinning inside, and a hand check, nickel dimer, called on Shanice Johnson. That's her second, and it'll send UNCW to the stripe for a 1-1.
Really tough way to pick up that second foul in the last minute, especially in the last play where the UNC Wilmington player pretty much went over her back, at least the crowd thought so, and even though there was good hustle. But tough. Erica Brown now with two. Shanice Johnson now with two.
Johnson will head to the bench as a result. Alicia Bell replacing her. Front end of the 1-1 here for Teague is good. She'll get one more. 62% foul shooter. Wilmington, to their credit, have knocked down free throws today. 8 of 9 at the stripe. Delaware much better than they were. It almost have to be against James Madison. They're 8 of 11 at the line tonight. Second foul shot good. Again, a 4-point game at 24-20.
And UNCW, again, with that full court pressure that has been, you know, they've done a good job taking time off the shot clock.
52 seconds as Delaware gets it across the midcourt stripe. They hit a trailing Richards, who turns all the way around to look back at her head coach. 45 seconds left to the half. Right wing dish to Bell. Bell high post. Jardine turn and face. 14-footer from the elbow. Wouldn't go. Offensive board. Buchanan ripped it away. Her follow. Back rim. And then an over-the-back foul caught on Akima Richards. We will walk the length for free throws. And that's the second foul on Richards. And maybe in that situation, Buchanan should have pulled that one out. There was a 6-second differential, 7-second differential shot. Game clock could have held virtually for the last shot.
Yeah, and that's one of those possessions with a big player where it's like, you know, you're asking her to shoot all the time, and that's the one time that she goes up and shoots and probably could have pulled it out. And, you know, you're not going to say anything bad about Kelsey Buchanan taking that shot, but unfortunate now, Akima Richards, the third player with two fouls.
First free throw is good, making it 24-21. Second shot rattles home, so it's 24-22. Obviously easier said than done. Some schlub over here can just say, oh, pull it out, pull it out. But in the heat of the battle, Buchanan thought she had an open look. Here comes Richards, angle dribble across the timeline towards the left wing. 4-second differential here, shot and game clock. Delaware should be patient. Near corner, Green head fake to three, drove inside, got stripped from behind, and now a tie-up. Arrow belongs to Wilmington. So if you're going to turn it over, that's the way to do it. You lose possession, but you will get it to start the second half at least.
Well, I guess that's looking on the bright side, Matt, but I don't think that's the time to lose the ball when it's 14 seconds left. The end of the first half. No. I don't think Tina Martin thinks that's a good time to lose the ball.
I guarantee you she doesn't think it's a good time to lose the ball. But she had at least lost it and then tied the player up. That was the silver lining.
I know what you're saying.
Atkins on the left wing. Dragged her pivot foot. No call. Feeds up top to Teague. Right wing dish over to Reeves. Reeves inside of Flowers. Drop step. Baby hook. Scooping layup. Try wouldn't go. Ugly. Rebound Jardine. And that takes us to halftime. That first half final possession kind of summed up the opening 20 minutes. It was not pretty, but it could have been much worse for Delaware down big early. They have a 2-point lead at intermission.
And just looking at the body language of the coaching staff, they are so not pleased with this response from this team. And credit to UNCW. You know, they're 1-15. They're coming into a, you know, an environment where it's a good crowd. And they are fighting. They have nothing to lose. They don't care that they're 1-15. And that's what Delaware has to realize. You get into conference play, nobody cares that you have Delaware on your chest. They're going to come in and they're going to go after it hard. And a young team has to learn some of these lessons.
Toe-to-toe with the Hens to this point. Delaware by just 2 at the break. We'll take a timeout, send it back to our Newcastle studios for the halftime report. Andrew Robertson back there. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 1410 WDOV.
A new year with the same great Blue Hens beat. We are back. I'm Scott Klaskin.
Happy New Year, all the Blue Hens fans out there. I'm Jimmy Smith. Great show coming up for you, and we're happy to be back.
Coming up, Meet the Hens is back as softball speedster Jessica Grizzler answers the tough questions, and basketball is into conference play. So how about an inside listen to head coach Monte Ross during the stressful CAA opener versus Hofstra?
And Scott will have your Blue Hens sports update, but before all of that, with the MLS Super Draft coming up on January 16th, we sit down and talk with head men's soccer coach Ian Hennessy and talk about the professional prospects for two of his senior standouts.
Prince has had a great season for us. He's part of the reason along with Vinny, that we scored so many goals, because Prince's ability to come forward from a left full-back position is an important part of how we play. I think because he is a left-sided player, that Prince has the ability to be drafted, because there's not that many quality left-sided players, at least from what we've seen this year. So I would not be surprised if he ends up in the professional ranks. Prince's strengths are his technical ability. He's wonderfully gifted on the ball. It's not a problem for him. Very strong physically. He's got all the attributes that it takes to be an MLS player. But at the next level, the professional level, it's not just about the technical ability. It's also the tactical ability, and that's where he really will have to step up his game, because at the next level, the speed and pace of things is so much quicker than a college game, and that's something I think he'll need a training camp and some years to figure out. Yeah, Vinny is for me one of the best passing midfielders in the country. His ability to strike a ball over different distances unparalleled, and I think will suit the MLS with the wide open kind of style of play that many of them do play, a very good brand of soccer. So from that perspective, I think his chances of going are good. If not in the draft, then at least to be invited for training. Very gifted technically, sees the game well, works both sides of the ball, and I think he'll be a surprise pickup for many MLS teams, and as he was a surprise pickup for us, he really was a dark horse and was had a wonderful career here at the University of Delaware. Vinny's best position is in the middle of the field. His ability to hit targets from any area is really one of the strengths of his game, and it's not often you see in the MLS people with the quality of passing that he has. I wouldn't say it's Beckhamish, but he's up there. There's no question about that. He can strike a ball wonderfully over distance at ease. It's not a struggle for him at all. The thing that Vince has to learn the next level is also, again, just reading the play quicker. That you know, you're not allowed the time that he'll see in the college ranks. You know, some games you're under the cosh and you have to make decisions that are game-changing decisions, and that happen over milliseconds. And that's something that I think he's able to do. But to do it on a consistent basis, that's the measure of a pro. We try to build our program around a strong spine, and Vinny certainly is part of that, and he is a huge loss for us. His training habits, his work ethic are second to none, and you know, positionally that becomes a gaping hole for us next year that we're going to look within the squad to fill, and also to bring someone from the outside as a freshman in to come in, and if he can do half as good a job as Vinny has done, then we'll be okay next year. Success leaves clues, and when you have the level of success, whether it's NCAA appearances or CEA championships, academic All-Americans, All-Americans, then I think it's probably an indication that you're on the right track. And for these guys, it just raises the profile of themselves, of the soccer program, and of the university. So we're absolutely, obviously thrilled that they were wonderful ambassadors and represent the university in the classroom and on the field as much as they have, and hopefully sets the bar higher now for the next guys coming in, that they too want to be All-American, they too want to turn pro and have the success that this senior class has shown over the last 4 years.
Hi, I'm Jessica Grisler, junior outfielder on the Blue Hens softball team. One thing people might be surprised to know about me is I moved to Washington, D.C. from California. My favorite song to listen to before games is probably Fun, Some Nights, or I usually put it on Pandora and just go from there. Other than softball, I enjoy shopping. That's pretty much my go-to. Or being with family. It's my favorite thing to do. My most memorable moment would probably be my freshman year, CAAs. We were playing JMU in the seventh inning. We were down by 4, and I hit a 2-run home run. My teammates are family. I don't even consider them teammates. We're, you know, 18 sisters out there.
Has anybody ever said you look like somebody?
I've gotten that I look like Taylor Swift before.
Really?
I don't see that since 5'2", and she's not. And I can't sing at all, so. If my life was on the line and I had to karaoke a song, I would probably bring it back to NSYNC, since I actually know all the words to that. Probably Bye Bye Bye. Everyone knows that, right? Bye Bye Bye. Do I need a dance move?
Can you? I mean, we
if I could trade lives with somebody, it would probably be Ricky Henderson, the Oakland A's baseball player. He's been my idol since I was little. I'm an Oakland A's fan. Been to all the games. My trainer in California actually was his brother-in-law. Two things I can't live without is family, obviously, and I don't want to say it, but my cell phone. You knew that was coming. One word my teammates would use to describe me is probably childish, because I act like I'm 12 out there. I like to bring, you know, fun and light into every situation, but definitely am a five-year-old little boy out there. So that's a little bit about me, junior outfielder Jessica Grizzler. Go Blue Hens.
It's time for our first sports update of the new year. So let's start in the pool as the seven seniors of Delaware swimming and diving team shine as the Blue Hens defeated both Drexel and Northeastern on senior day. The class of 2014 accounted for 9 top finishes as the Blue Hen men defeated Drexel 165 to 140.5. The Delaware women topped Northeastern 163.5 to 136.5 and dominated Drexel 218 to 79. The Delaware men were led by Corey Camp and Alex Hillsley, who were the only Blue Hens to tally 2 first-place finishes. Alex Tooley, Tim Ware, Zach Lowe, and Colin Hall each earned 1 first-place finish. For the Blue Hen women, the 200 medley relay squad earned a first-place finish against both Drexel and Northeastern. The squad that earned a 145.69 finish consisted of Alyssa Sanders, Annie Noons, Caitlin Walla, and Morgan White. In the only other relay event of the meet, the Blue Hens also earned a first-place finish. The 400 freestyle relay team of Maggie Tracy, Mary Kay Harris, Dominique Montoya, and White finished the heat in 333.36. Delaware returns to CAA action Saturday, January 25th, when the Hens travel to Towson to take on the Tigers. The meet is set to begin at 1 p.m. On to the hardwood now as Blue Hens men's basketball held off James Madison on the road 78-74, giving Blue Hen head coach Monte Ross his 100th career victory. Delaware won its season best 4th straight game, improving to 10-7 overall and 2-0 in the CAA. Senior Devon Sadler led the Blue Hens with 25 points off the bench, while Davon Usher added 21 points and knocked down 5 three-pointers. Jarvis Threet tossed in 16 points, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists. Delaware will look for its 5th straight win on Wednesday when the Blue Hens host William & Mary at 7 p.m. Women's hoops now, where the trip to Harrisonburg didn't go quite as well. James Madison University stifled the Blue Hens 87-51 in the largest loss since 2008 for the Hens. The loss marks the first for Delaware in CAA regular season and tournament action since the 2010-11 season when the Dukes defeated the Blue Hens 67-61 in the championship final of the CAA tournament. Freshman Erica Brown led Delaware with 12 points and a career-high 9 rebounds, in addition to 2 assists, as senior Kelsey Buchanan added 10 points and 8 rebounds. The Blue Hens return home for a matchup against the Seahawks of UNCW this Friday at 7 p.m. Get tickets for both men's and women's games on BlueHens.com or by calling 302-831-2257. Let's take a look at the upcoming schedule.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Season of intense competition. Only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow.
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals. Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Then we are tied.
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
Welcome back to the show. With the all-important start to conference play for Delaware men's basketball, we thought it'd be fun to mic up head coach Monte Ross and hear what the game sounded like Lucky for us, we got a good one as the Hens and Hofstra battled to the end. So here it is. Here's Coach Ross and what he had to say about it.
First thing we have to do is we have to make sure everybody, if we're going to take this journey, that we're all going the same direction. We all got to get there. Everybody has an important role. Everybody has an important role in this journey. We need everybody just to do their job. Everybody is equally important. Everybody's equally important. We need you to do your job, though. We need you to do your job. Your job has been clearly defined to you. We need you to do that. We don't need you to do more. We don't need you to do less. We need you to do your job. Now, what we need you to do is do your job at the highest level. We need every single guy to follow the plan. We'll look up and we'll be amazed at where we are. How you doing, man?
How's
you
all right?
Happy New Year to
you. I'm good, man. Family good and everything?
Good. Good.
Hey, man. How you doing, man?
Good.
What's up, Bennett Alley?
What's up, Mike?
Are you mic'd up tonight?
I'm mic'd up.
Let's go, KA.
Let's go, Jarmo. Everybody talk. Watch. It's intimidating when we talk, fellas. It's intimidating. Let's be intimidating out there with our talk. Hey, let's establish ourselves right away and let them know what this thing is going to be about for 40 minutes. All right? Let's go. Together on three. One, two, three. Let's go now. Yeah! Oh! Hey! Talk, guys. We got to talk.
You hear us?
Marvin. Hey, box out here. Box out. Come on, young. We ain't playing no defense, guys, because we're not talking. We got to communicate on defense, all right? Us. All right. We got to climb our way back out of this. We got to climb our way out. We got to get some stops down here, all right? Oh, it's a foul. Go. And one! Now back! Box! Come on, talk! All right, Mo, go. No, he went like that, Clarence! You missed that one. No, why? He swung like that. Can't miss that one. Come on, Clarence, come on. Power! All right, we got to get it right here. Hey, come on, guys. Be smart. Let's finish the game out. Come on. Good job. We got what we came to get. We're 1-0 in the league. You cannot get to 2-0 if you don't get to 1-0. So I'm proud of you. Congratulations for the win. Together on three. One, two, three.
Together. Coaching, it is a stressful profession, but the Hens, with great poise and a great effort to beat Hofstra, open up CAA play 1-0, win their fourth straight CAA conference opener. Big thanks to head coach Monte Ross for letting us listen what it takes to be a coach on those Delaware sidelines. And a big thank you to everyone who brought this show together, and a big thank you to everyone watching at home. For Jimmy Smith, I'm Scott Klatskin, and as always, go Hens.
Out and you get the high post shot. Very good.
Hens in the zone, right wing with it on the attack. Reeves tries to drive towards the lane. Fadeaway jumper over Buchanan is good. Not great defense, but that was a tough shot.
It was a tough shot, but she shouldn't have been able to get in that close to make that shot.
Here comes Richards. Nobody stops the ball, so she'll dribble to the foul line. Stops and pops and misses a 15-footer. Straightaway jumper wouldn't go. Rebound Reeves. He comes the other way to Atkins. Left her feet, got away with it. Found Teague at the last second. Back to Atkins, who hands off to Mobley to set things up. Mobley top of the circle. Leaves it for Reeves. Left wing. Far quarter to Atkins. Atkins with 12 to shoot. Passing back towards the quarter. Tipped by Johnson. It touched the sideline, so it'll stay with Wilmington with 11 to shoot.
And Shanice Johnson does a really nice job on that outside back line. You know, down here, she did a nice job closing out here. Active hands on the line, up the line, in the passing lane, and that's important.
And now goes to Mobley. Mobley bounce pass right wing to Atkins, trying to drive baseline on Jardine. Threw it away. Nice steal on the rotation by Brown. Two-on-one with Richards. Feeds it to Akima, and she'll power dribble miss, but the rebound Buchanan. Her follow too strong off the window. Rebound Mobley. Long outlet to Atkins. One-on-two. Got away with a walk. Then left it off. Nobody home. Out of bounds. Back to Delaware.
A couple times now, Atkins has left her feet without knowing what she was going to do with the basketball, and she has interesting footwork. It seems like she's walking a little bit, but they're not picking it up.
Well, it seems pretty obvious she's walking.
I was trying to say that tactfully.
Wow, I just don't know how they didn't call that. It's okay, though. Hens got the stop anyway. Now they throw over the top to Buchanan against the pressure, who finds Brown trailing the play to set things up. Left wing dish to Richards. Richards circles towards the top of the right-hand dribble. Picks up her bounce, try to go back door to Jardine. Missed her. Out of bounds, turnovers, and sloppy play continue to start the second half.
Oh, my goodness. And Tina Martin literally taking Courtney Green and throwing her off the bench to go get Akima Richards out. Tina Martin coaching her up right now on the sideline, not pleased at all with those few possessions by Akima Richards.
With the ball top of the circle, with it Amber Reeves. Reeves picking up her bounce, feeding over to Atkins. Atkins up top to Reeves. Reeves right-hand dribble towards the wing. Feeds up top to Teague. Teague floats it over to Reeves. Reeves back to Mobley. Mobley splits the top. Dribbles to the foul line. Got her shot blocked by Courtney Green. A tie-up. Arrow keeps it with UNC Wilmington.
Nice.
You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 1410 WDOV Dover. And on 1290, the ticket, WWTX Wilmington, 26-24, Delaware lead, 17:57 left. Inbound goes to Mobley on the left blocker. Shot one go, rebound Buchanan.
Much better job there by the back line, straight up and in the correct position. And funny things happen when you play the defense right.
Green left wing feeding high post. Buchanan turns the corner and finishes a layup with the right hand.
And that's what Kelsey Buchanan can give you. She can shoot around the basket. She can shoot outside, but she can also put that ball on the ground and make move.
Hens by four, 28-24, 17:33 left second half. With it right wing, Atkins feeding up top to Teague. Teague jab step, dishing over to Mobley, back to Teague. Boy, UNC Wilmington so passive around the perimeter. Now they get a high post, flash to Reeves. Reeves to Teague, back to Reeves, driving towards the elbow. Got a blocking foul called on Erica Brown as she forced her way in. And that's going to be the third foul on Erica Brown. Delaware's only active true point guard with 17:14 left still in the second half.
Such a crucial point in the game right now because she picks up that third foul and the bench just not deep enough for the Hens tonight.
You have Alicia Bell, Joy Caracciolo, Jade Clark, and Akima Richards that have played, but Richards is going to come in and try to spell her at the point as the first free throw is good, but we've seen that this year. That's not her natural position. Akima's just not all that comfortable there.
No, and it takes her out of her game, and it's a lot of pressure for someone who's not used to bringing the ball up and running the offense, and it changes your mentality towards the half-court offense.
Second free throw is good as well, 28-26. The Delaware edge down to two. Richards dribbling backcourt for UD. Crossing over left side of the floor, getting it across the timeline with 24 left on the shot clock. Dribbling towards the wing. Crossover move towards the top of the key. Now turns the corner, explodes towards the rim. Lost it on the way up. Johnson ended up with it. Her left-hand try wouldn't go. Rebounds loose on the floor and finally grabbed by UNCW. Johnson and Richards both collide there with Reeves dribbling into the forecourt. And they'll give the foul to Richards, and that's her third. So now both point guards, one a true point, one playing out of position, are in foul trouble. And Brown's going to come back. Richards is going to go out. And that's not so much because of the foul. That's because of the frustration at the decision by the senior.
Yeah, it's because of both. And wow. Three fouls for both the guards.
Two-point Delaware lead. 3:20 into this second half. Teague top of the circle. Looking over her options. Left hand bounce, lobs it into the corner, far side of the floor to Hamby, or excuse me, to Mobley. Mobley dribbling towards the top, try to awkward angle feed to the left block. It's tipped out of bounds off the hands of Atkins, and it'll go back to Delaware. I think the Hens even thought that was staying with UNCW, but it just tipped off the shoulder or the arm area there of Atkins.
They'll take it. They'll take that break. And if you are Erica Brown, you have to do everything humanly possible to not pick up that fourth foul.
Brown gives it to Johnson, lob over the top to Jardine, who finds Green back to Brown to set things up. 18 on the timer as Delaware begins the offensive set. Up top to Johnson, left-hand dribble towards the basket, stops her bounce, feeds Jardine left wing. She'll drive towards the left block, back to Johnson, lane opens up for her, she attacks off the dribble, misses too strong off the glass, and then Kelsey Buchanan called for the foul on the rebound attempt. With 16:02 left, second half, the Delaware edge two, already the third team foul on UD. Good news, only the second foul on Buchanan.
What a great drive by Shanice Johnson on the left side, but just you gotta use your left hand, and she didn't have the angle and threw it right over the rim.
Right side of the floor, Reeves for Wilmington. Dishing off to Mobley. Inside, a steal here by Johnson. She's going to try to go coast to coast all the way to the basket. Got off with her footwork, but got bumped there by Reeves. And Johnson will head to the stripe to shoot two. Great steal there by Johnson. Awkward footwork, but bailed out by the foul. We'll take a timeout. 15:44 left to go in the second half. Delaware 28, UNC Wilmington 26. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV. UNC Wilmington 26, Blue Hens Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV, being brought to you by Legacy Pharmacy, creating rub-ins for where it hurts. For more info, visit summitrx.com. That's summitrx.com. Shanice Johnson at the line to shoot two out of the media timeout. Great steal by Shanice, but for the second consecutive trip, just awkward footwork costing her a layup.
And that's where you have to learn. You need to keep your stride. She was trying to absorb the contact, and then you can't gather yourself as she misses the first free throw. You just need to go up in stride and let the, you know, focus on making and not worry about the contact.
If they foul you, great. Mm-hmm. And they did. She misses both free throws, though. Right rim the first, rattled out the second. Wilmington the rebound. They race it into the forecourt. Atkins trying to drive baseline. Good job by Delaware to get back defensively. She'll feed outside to Mobley. Mobley will set things up. 15:30 left in this second half. Atkins right wing. Up top to Teague. Left wing Mobley deep two. Back rim. Rebound. Offensive board. Weak side Flowers. Follow good. And we are tied. 28-28 with 15:15 left in the second half.
Yeah, keeping in mind that Tina Martin is mic'd up for this game and the cameras have been on her, and it might be you might want to watch that and see some of the things she's saying to the team tonight.
Might be occasional bleep. Johnson top of the circle, banks it in. I don't think she called it, but she'll take it, a deep two, and it's 30-28.
Yeah, it'll be very interesting. They did that with Monte Ross during the last game, and they're doing that with Tina Martin tonight. She's mic'd up, and there'll be some highlights.
Yeah, the next Blue Hens beat on BlueHens.com. Jimmy Smith and his Hens All Access team do a great job with it. They force a tough shot here to the Blue Hens, and it's off the front rim. Rebound, Green. Green racing it the other way. Johnson, far corner, dishing outside to Brown, and Brown will reset the offense. 14:28, ticking left, second half. Erica Brown left wing, feeding high post Johnson. looks opposite, far corner. Jardine head fake to three, now backing down on Atkins, scooped it up and in. Hannah Jardine, what a move.
Now the fans are seeing what the coaching staff in this team has been seeing in practice all year. She's starting to feel comfortable and really settling into this Delaware squad.
She can play a little
yes,
bit.
Yes, she can.
Atkins, right wing, circling towards the top. Left-hand chest pass goes over to Reeves. Cross court to Atkins. Atkins inside to Teague. Lost it, but got it back. Dishes off to Reeves. Reeves lost her handle. Gave it to Teague. Johnson tried to steal it from her. And that's a reach-in foul. And that's something Shanice Johnson's got to learn. She just picks up her third foul. When you can get the steal, great. She gambles maybe a tad too often.
Yeah, the team, the defense as a whole gambles a little bit too often, which is one of the reasons why a lot of the players have been in foul trouble this year. And that's the discipline, that's the youth of this team. You know, you have to trust the system. You have to play and do your job. And if you take too many chances, it breaks down the defense.
Reeves toss it in to Atkins. Atkins down low on the right block. The Flowers double team comes at a timeout called by UNC Wilmington. We're going to take it with the Seahawks. 13:39 left to go in the second half. It's Delaware 32, UNC Wilmington 28. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on 12-9 of the ticket at 1410 WDOV.
Enjoy Blue Hens basketball this season at the Bob with ticket specials, including youth group packages. The Slam Dunk Hoops and Scoops deal to enjoy U Dairy ice cream with Blue Hens basketball, game packs, and CAA mini plans to catch all the high-flying CAA basketball action at the Bob this winter. For more information, visit BlueHens.com today.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Christiana and Middletown, visit them online at GlasgowMedicalCenter.com. I'm Matt Janis, alongside Christine Coronmata, Andrew Robertson back at our Newcastle studios. Delaware by 4, 32-28. Again, really no way to describe it other than it's been an ugly game, but you have to be happy that every time Wilmington has punched Delaware in the mouth, the Hens have found a response. And that's a good sign for a young basketball team.
And that's a difference. Granted, JMU is picked to win the league and UNCW is picked to last, but they're still responding. And with this young team, they're in a little bit of a lull. You know, this is midway through the season and kind of hit that wall, and they need to break through that wall.
Inbound here goes to Mobley, weaving her way into the lane, kicks it out to Atkins, far corner, leaves it inside to Teague. Teague, turnaround jumper, banks it in. Nice finish inside by Nakia Teague, and it's 32-30.
And that's where you see some of the athleticism of this young UNC squad, and they've had some nice young players. They just need more of them.
Good feed over the top by Buchanan to Jade Clark in the forecourt, but Clark elects not to attack. Instead, dishes out to Brown. Left wing feed on a bounce pass to Green. Green will attack. Tries to finish left hand, couldn't get it to go, but Buchanan cleans it up on the offensive glass.
Good things happen when you drive to the basket when it's open and you don't force it. And even though she missed that shot, Kelsey Buchanan there to clean it up.
34-30, the Delaware lead back to four. 12:50 left. Second half, a tip pass here by Green. Ball will trickle out of bounds. It'll stay with UNC Wilmington. McMillan going to return. She'll replace Amber Reeves. And here's where you wonder, does UNC Wilmington start to wear down?
Sure. I mean, like you said, they only play seven. They have eight suited up. It's tiring. They're fighting every ounce, and Delaware is the better team here, but credit to UNCW. They are playing their hearts out.
Here's Atkins, left wing, trying to fight her way into the lane. Leaves it off to Teague on the left block. Teague forced one up. Got it blocked by Clark, and then Clark did a good job to corral the loose ball.
Nice job there by Jade Clark, and kind of swung the ball free to make sure she was guarding it.
Here's Jade Clark with it now, left wing. Up top, Buchanan, deep two, left rim. Straightaway jumper. It was about an 18-footer, and then Buchanan, silly reach. On the rebound attempt, you like that she's hustling, but you got to know when to hold him, know when to fold him, as Kenny Rogers once said.
Oh, boy. Anyway, Kelsey Buchanan, you got to know the moments here. Your team is starting to pick things up. And why have they picked things up? Because they're driving to the basket. To take a shot a little bit behind the free throw line early in the shot clock, maybe not the best choice, although, you know, Kelsey Buchanan has a green light. Probably could have got a little bit of a better shot on that possession.
You're right about that. 12:18 left. It was a third foul on Buchanan. Mm-hmm. Hens have multiple players with three fouls. Good news is you start to run out of time, 12 minutes to go. Foul shouldn't be a huge issue, but you got to be careful. Wilmington with the ball. Atkins near corner, down by four, driving, leaving her feet, but finding a teammate. Left side Mobley. Mobley into the lane. Back out to Atkins. Right wing deep. Too good. Foot on the line, and she buried it.
And the problem with the fouls starting to rack up individually is that they're also starting to rack up as a team. Delaware with five team fouls, and the Seahawks only with one.
It's Caracciolo, Buchanan, and Clark in the front court. Brown and Green in the back court for UD. Hens by two, 11:40 left, second half. Brown dribbling in front of her own bench. Tough entry feed to Buchanan. Nice look opposite to Clark. Deep baseline two, front rimmed it. Offensive rebound. Buchanan went up with a follow and was fouled. And Kelsey Buchanan will shoot two when we come back. We have a timeout on the floor with 11 minutes and 31 seconds left to go in the second half. Delaware 34, UNC Wilmington 32. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on 12-9 of the Ticket and 14-10 WDOV.
A season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow.
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Denver, we are tied.
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
And five.
34-32, the Delaware lead is just a deuce, but you got Kelsey Buchanan at the free throw line for two foul shots. 11:31 left to go in the second half in a game where Delaware is shooting just 34% from the field. UNC Wilmington a paltry 27%. Buchanan hitting the first free throw. Hens now as a team 9 of 14 from the stripe. Wilmington hanging around, though, because they're getting the line as well. Buchanan hits a pair. The lead is 4. UNCW 13 of 14 from the foul line.
And that's one of the reasons why they've been able to hang around in this game, because they're getting some of those free throws. But again, Delaware with 5 team fouls and UNCW only with 2. And that's going to come into play in this last 11-18.
There's a left wing feed to Mobley. Mobley with the basketball, dribbling towards the top of the circle. Had it stripped by Green. Nice hustle. Caracciolo to the floor after it. And a tie-up will give the arrow to Delaware. Joy Caracciolo, a head-first dive into the pile.
Yeah, Joy Caracciolo and Jade Clark doing a lot of little things in this game. Active, diving to the floor, trying to secure the ball. When things aren't going well, you just have to find other ways to contribute.
They're doing that right now. But the Hens need some offense. Up by four, they'd really like to get rid of this UNC Wilmington team as they're able to break some pressure, pass over the top to Buchanan. Left wing dribble, Brown. Brown up top to Green, curling off the screen. Green didn't have the space to pull the trigger. Leaves it to Clark, right wing triple, round and out. And a board grab by McMillan. McMillan outlets it to Atkins. Two on two in the open floor. Atkins will scoop one up left hand. Couldn't get it to go. Three Hens fighting for the ball. Got away with a walk. Brown ends up with it. Whirling dervish dribble to free herself up. Finds Green ahead of the pack. And Green contorts for the right hand finish.
Nice little hop, skip, and a jump there by Courtney Green to get away from the much larger Flowers player and avoid the block shot. Nice job.
10:17 left second half. Hens up by six. Trying to sneak away from UNCW, a pesky Seahawk team, just 1-15 coming in. Mobley, though, an answer. Deep two, foul line right. About an 18-footer, and it's 38-34.
still hanging around, and you can't give up that shot. I'd love to see Erica Brown on these high screens turn the corner a little bit and really attack the basket.
Again, over the top of the pressure, Buchanan in the forecourt back to Brown. 16 on the timer. She dribbles left wing. Looking for Buchanan. Double team came from behind. Instead, they swing it around. Jade Clark, deep two, wouldn't go. And then a foul on the rebound. A reach-in call on Courtney Green. And that's going to be the 16th foul against Delaware. So UNCW is going to shoot on every foul the rest of the way.
And very fortunate, because really Kelsey Buchanan was the one who gave the contact there, and that would have been her fourth foul. So, yeah, it's not good it's the 16th foul, but good that that was on Courtney Green.
Going to be Clark, Caracciolo, and Green checking out. Richards, Johnson, and Jardine back in. Right wing bounce, Mobley. Mobley, cross-court feed to Atkins. Head fake to three, instead circles towards the top, leaves it off to Mobley. Foul line right jumper again is good.
Three straight outside shots there by UNC Wilmington, pretty much in the same spot.
Knowing their limitations, though, the mid-range shot, they're an awful three-point shooting team. Less than 20% as a group for the season. Richards up top to Johnson. Jab step on the dribble. Pulls up, 15-footer, would not go. Line drive shot. Rebound grab by UNC Wilmington. Johnson stole it, saved it inbounds. Sprawls into the seats, but Wilmington ends up with a ball. Atkins contorting her way into the lane. Couldn't finish with a right hand. Buchanan the rebound. What an outlet to Richards. Two on two with Jardine. Richards step back jumper. Good. Akima Richards baseline J is good. And the Hens back up by four.
Boy, did they need to convert that one. Akima Richards taking a little bit of a risk there with that outside shot, but she nails it.
That's another one. The coaching staff, no, no, no. Good shot, Akima. Here's a baseline jumper the other way. McMillan off the feed from Atkins. It's good. Another mid-range two.
You don't want to be trading basket for basket. Eventually, you need to start to extend this lead a little bit, again, by doing the little things.
You let a team hang around, and bad things can happen. 8:15 left to go. The lead is two for Delaware. Brown dribbling in front of her own bench, foul line right. Feeds high post Johnson. Nice turn of the corner with a left-hand bounce, and then a reach-in foul on the way up. It'll be two shots for Johnson as they'll call Nakia Teague. Getting a piece of the arm there of Johnson.
Yeah, Shanice Johnson, very active in this game. She's trying to make things happen offensively and defensively. And a little shout-out here to another former UD alum. Made a post on Facebook about Blue Hens are everywhere. You have Kim Tingley, the assistant coach for UNCW. Of course, Tierra Malcolm, one of the assistants for Delaware. I'm commentating the game. Christine Cole Jenkins is listening while she's at work till 1 a.m. on a shift. Ooh. And another one of our teammates here, Suzanne Street, supposed to be here with her newborn. So Blue Hens everywhere. Hashtag Blue Hens everywhere.
I like the spinoff on Blue Hen Nation. Delaware knocks down a pair at the free throw line, and the lead is four for UD. It's always cool to see former players surrounding the program, though. Right wing with it on the bounce, Amber Reeves. Reeves gives it off to DeAsia Kane. Kane across court dish, left side to Mobley. Mobley back to Reeves. Reeves on the baseline to Atkins. Nice dribble move to get by Jardine, but then she threw it away. The steal by Johnson. Outlet four to Richard. Nice feed to a trailing Buchanan who lays it home. Plus a foul. And grinning ear to ear on the beautiful pass. Richard Buchanan knew it. What a finish. Plus the contact. The lead six with a free throw coming and a timeout on the floor. 7:36 left to go in the first half.
That's more like it.
That is pretty basketball. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on 12-9 of the ticket at 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
What a feed by Richards to a running the floor big in Kelsey Buchanan.
Now that's one for the highlight reel. And directly across from us, this one of the female fans just stood up with her arms raised like, yeah, and you could just feel the energy in the building.
But Buchanan cannot convert the old-fashioned three-point play. Rebound grab by Wilmington, still down six, hanging around with 7:28 to go. Atkins left wing for the Seahawks. Dribbles towards the top, head fakes a deep two, and instead dishes off to Mobley. Mobley, she'll dribble towards the top. Dish over to Atkins, whose pocket's picked by Richards. Here comes Richards, racing to the basket, trying to beat Atkins, and will. Finish with a right hand. Hens by eight, 7:08 to go.
Akima Richards being a playmaker tonight.
She has been all over the place on defense and then some big finishes on the offensive end as well. She was the spark plug that got him back in it in the first half, too. Right side of the floor, Kane out top to Atkins. Atkins back to Kane. Deep jumper, back rim high, and then fell through. What a bounce. Timeout, UNC Wilmington. That thing went, what, 4 or 5 feet up in the air and then fell through softly.
And the entire crowd, kind of let the air out a little bit. But Delaware with a nice little run here. They want to keep this momentum going. And before, when I was talking about hashtag Blue Hens everywhere, we were naming some of the Blue Hens that are involved with both teams, coaches, and some former players. Also, Allison Trapp, a favorite here at the Bob Carpenter Center, was a very dynamic player. She is also here today, so welcoming her back to the Bob again as well.
As an alum, it means a lot to you guys, this program, to see how it is just kind of evolved forward, and they just find ways to continue to win games. And I know that you guys love being around these basketball team and just being a part of it still.
Yeah, it's kind of funny. The older you get, something just makes you want to give back. And, you know, a lot of my former teammates and teammates in between aren't very local. There's only a few of us that are local. So whenever somebody's able to come or there's a new addition to the Blue Hen family, someone has a baby or gets married, it's awesome to see each other. And it is a family. You've endured stuff together. And Blue Hen, UD Hoop Squad, we started that. Hashtag UD Hoop Squad.
You're saying things like the older we get and you're expecting me not to make a joke. Here's Delaware in the forecourt. Buchanan trying to rise and gets fouled on her way up, about a 15-footer. As I move forward and make a smart decision, Kelsey Buchanan made a good decision as well, and she'll head to the stripe for two more free throws.
And I made a really good decision because I didn't lean over and smack you on the shoulder there. So
Buchanan line left. Now, she is 4 of 5 at the stripe tonight. Make it 5 of 6 as she hits the first. The 47-40 Delaware edge with 6:27 still to go. There's enough time for Wilmington to probably have one more run, but you have to think that they're riding on fumes at this point. Second foul shot good. It's 48-40.
But the momentum and all of the energy right now with Delaware, and this is why you love home games, because the crowd is standing behind a team at the right time, knowing they need a lift and they need to shut the door on the Seahawks.
6:17 left. UNCW basketball. Mobley cross court to Atkins. They have been the offense for UNCW tonight. Atkins lost it, chased it down, and got it back. Feeding over right wing to Mobley. Mobley cross-court dish over to Atkins. Back to Mobley. Left her feet. Got away with a walk. Out to Atkins. Deep three. Wouldn't go. Weak side rebound. Jardine pulled it in. Nice board again by the freshman, who gives it to Richards. Richards outlets it forward to Johnson. Back to Richards. Akima wants to attack, thinks better of it. Finds Erica Brown, the point guard, to set things up.
And UNC Wilmington in a man-to-man offense now. They're really trying to be aggressive. They know they need stops.
Richards, jab step, 15-footer pure. What a night. Akima Richards, the senior, 12 points, great defense, and a 10-point Delaware edge.
It took a little while, but now it all seems to be coming together for Delaware. Pep in their step, really active, and a lot of energy.
Reeves up top, right wing down, step back, nowhere to go. Dishing off into the corner to Mobley, and Mobley hand-checked on her way towards the rim. And that's a 17 foul on UD, and it means free throws coming here for Wilmington.
And this is where you have to be disciplined. You have to be disciplined in the defense, in your defensive principles. You don't want to play passive, but you want to stay true to this defensive system.
So the foul shots are going to come from Bree Mobley. She's only a 63% foul shooter. It's easier said than done, though, because they've gotten so many steals, and that's really been the catalyst to get them going. But you're right, discipline's so important. And she misses the front end at half the floor. Didn't know it was a 1-1, so Delaware able to sneak in and get the rebound. About three players stood stationary, no clue.
And this is where you have carryover. All those little drills you do in practice, the end-of-game situations, got to carry it over to this part of the game.
But a steal as Johnson tried to force an entry feed to Buchanan, then Johnson stole it back. Brown after the floor to get it, and she's tied up. Unfortunately, the arrow belongs to UNC Wilmington. Delaware was trying to get a timeout, but I don't think Erica Brown had full control of the ball as they were calling for the TO.
Yeah, I'm not so sure. And even if she did, that back ref couldn't have seen it because her back was to him covering the ball.
Janine Radice was about 10 feet on the floor. She tried to get into an angle where the official could see her. But it'll be UNC Wilmington with the basketball. 4:57 left, second half. Big trip here. Seahawks need points. Johnson. Oh, she ripped it away. Richards ends up with it on the deflection. 3-on-1. Brown gets the pass. Left hand finish wouldn't go, but a rebound and a foul caught on Wilmington. Boy, the Hens turning defense into offensive opportunity.
And what leadership from Akima Richards. Did you see her direct Erica Brown? Tell her, go wider in transition, so she was able to make that pass.
Only the 16th foul on the Seahawks. It's the fourth on Ryan Flowers. And Flowers is going to come out of the game. She'll be replaced by De'Asia Kane. And the Hens will throw it in with a fresh 30, up by 10 with 4 3/4 minutes left. Inbound. Oh, Richards threw it off the back of the defense and then tried to put the shot up. Got blocked out of bounds, and she's lucky she got the basketball back.
You know, not only do I wish they, you know, I'm glad they have Tina Martin mic'd up. I would like them to mic up Janine Radice, too.
That would be good, I think, Hens all access, as they call it. Here's Richards getting the inbound up top and hitting a 16-footer, and then a foul under the basket. Going to be caught on Kelsey Buchanan after the shot went through. So the basket will count, but we will walk the length of the floor, and Nakia Teague will shoot free throws, a 1-and-1, as Buchanan is called for her fourth foul after the made bucket.
Boy, is Akima Richards feeling it tonight, though. What a second half for Akima Richards. So confident in her shot and just aggressive, just like Tina Martin wants her to be. Great, great game by Akima Richards tonight.
Well, that was a cold reception on the bench for Kelsey Buchanan as she came over. No need for a microphone there. Not many words between her and Tina Martin. Free throw no good. Long rebound grabbed by Joy Caracciolo as she missed the front end. And that's a mistake there by Buchanan that she just doesn't normally make. So I think you forgive her this one time.
You do, but that's your senior leader. You need her out there. Need her out there.
Here's Brown, a crossover move towards the left side of the floor. Brown now circling back to the top. Gives it off to Richards on the baseline. Richards drives, draws the defense, leaves it off for Caracciolo, right-hand finish. What a game for Akima Richards. Hens by 14.
Akima Richards doing it all, defensively, offensively, getting others involved. Fantastic.
Top of the circle, Mobley. Time running down on Wilmington now. The Hens seem to have control, up 54-40 with 3:50 to go. Right wing, with it Reeves. Cross-court feed, left side Mobley, calling out a play. Almost lost it. Gives it off to Kane. Kane into the corner, far side to McMillan. McMillan forces one up over Johnson, front rimmed it. Rebound tip and out of bounds off of Erica Brown. It'll stay with UNC Wilmington when we come back. Final chance to catch your breath. Right now, though, it's looking like an easy one for the Hens. We'll see if they can hold on. 3:36 to go. Delaware 54, UNC Wilmington 40. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on 12.9 of the Ticket and 14.10 WDOV. Welcome back to the Carpenter Center. The inbound goes to McMillan, near side of the floor. 3:32 and ticking left second half. Delaware 54, UNC Wilmington 40. And a hand check foul going to be called here on Akima Richards. That's Delaware's 19th foul. Fourth foul on Richards. Free throws coming for UNCW. And that's really the last thing Delaware wants to do right now.
Yeah, this is where, you know, the basketball IQ comes into play. Even though you're young, you know, you're halfway through the season now, you need to take all those little things, not have mental lapses. And Courtney Green now entering the game for Akima Richards as Akima picks up her fourth foul.
And Akima's not young. That's the one thing. Everybody else on the floor can use that as an excuse. First free throw, good. She'll get one more, but Akima Richards has been so good tonight. I'm going to give her a pass. I don't think the coaching staff might, but I'm going to give her a free pass on just this one.
Yeah, one of the best games I've seen her play since the ODU game down in Old Dominion, and she was fantastic there. She tends to play really well against these athletic teams, and it goes back and forth, really. Just excels.
Suits her strength. This is a second free throw good. The lead for Delaware down to a dozen. 3:24 to go. Hens just got to be smart with the ball at this point, and foul to the backcourt. Erica Brown, an extra 17 foul on Wilmington, and that means free throws coming here for UD.
And here, you know, with the stoppage of the clock and UNC Wilmington is going to start fouling, whether it's intentional or unintentional, you have to convert on these free throws, because if you don't want to trade baskets, they come down, hit three, you miss more free throws, you're giving them possessions and you're coming up empty. So really important to hit the free throws here.
Were you surprised the way UNC Wilmington changed their offensive attack as Brown hits the first free throw at about the 6 minute mark of the first half? They went from attack mode to all of a sudden they became passive and they were never able to get it going again.
And I think that was a direct correlation to Atkins coming out of the game for whatever reason. I don't know if it was a rest or I mean, she wasn't in foul trouble. And, you know, they stopped attacking. They stopped penetrating.
Second foul shot good as well. 56-42. 14-point Delaware edge. Atkins driving. Good defense by Green to stay in front but not foul. The dish goes over right wing to Reeves. Back to Atkins, top of the circle to Reeves. Head fake to three. Drives, gets it out to McMillan. McMillan to the foul line. 14-footer, no good, but a foul. And this one's going to be on Courtney Green. 2:59 left. It's the third foul on Green. Hens have a lot of players with a lot of fouls, but somehow have avoided any of them fouling out.
Yeah, the Cardinal sin. You cannot foul the jump shot. You cannot foul the jump shot.
So two free throws coming here for McMillan, particularly a team that shoots the jumper as poorly as Wilmington does. First foul shot is good. UNCW 32%. They are shooting it a little bit better in the second half. They're 1 of 8 for deep. It's going to be virtually impossible for them to erase this kind of deficit down 13 with 2:59 to go.
But credit to this team. I mean, if you've come in here, you're not going to think they're 1 in 15 the way they tried to stick with the Hens.
Not at all. As McMillan hits the second, so it's back to a dozen with 2:59 to go. Still technically within striking distance. Richards looking and getting it into Caracciolo, and they're going to call a hold behind the play. Or they'll call a timeout. I beg your pardon. Thought the official had a hold. He says Tina Martin called timeout before Delaware could get it in. With 2:52 left to go, 12-point lead. And in this spot, if you protect it and you make free throws, UNC Wilmington has no chance to beat you.
Absolutely. And again, you don't want to take the air out of the ball. You don't want to be too passive, but you want to use the shot clock. You want to play smart. If you need to draw fouls, you draw fouls. You know, Delaware keeps on doing what they've been doing in the last 8 minutes or so, and they should be in good shape.
What is the overall, I think, how do you feel about this game? I guess is the best way to put it. It was not pretty. It was certainly a bad first 12 to 13 minutes. It's a 1-15 team that challenged you throughout the second half, but it seemed like you did find a response every time.
I'd call it a baby step. I'd call it a baby step to getting back to where you thought you were before you had that reality check against JMU. So, yeah, the first half was awful, but they showed improvement in the second half. And you know, the play of Akima Richards is something to build on, but a baby step, because you still have to go back to the drawing board. And then you have Drexel coming in here, a heated rivalry on Sunday, and you know they're not going to take it easy. And Abby Reddick, in her last game last night, had a triple-double against Towson.
They hammered. I think it was William & Mary.
Oh, William & Mary. I'm sorry.
40-point win. Granted, the Tribe aren't very good, but, man, did they play well in their last time out on the rope. Inbound goes to Buchanan, a lob entry feed, and back to Brown, who does a good job to work her way into the forecourt. Crowd wanted a hand check. That was a performance that Denise Dillon could not say enough good things about the way her team played. Here's a lob entry to Buchanan. She's fouled on the way up for the right block. That was Teague that gave the contact. So two free throws coming. And that's another chance for Delaware to kind of prove themselves after what happened at JMU. You know, the Hens are not supposed to be among the league's elite, but after a 10-3 start, 2-0 beginning the league action, you were hoping that maybe they were a little bit further along than they were. JMU was a wake-up call. The first half tonight was another, but after they hit the snooze button, they finally responded to the alarm as Buchanan hits the first free throw.
And, you know, Tina Martin talked a lot in the pregame interview about inconsistencies, and that's really the mark of a youthful team, and but you have to fight through those inconsistencies and try to get something going as Kelsey Buchanan hits her second free throw.
How frustrating can that be as a coach when your team, you know they know what you want them to do, they just aren't executing it?
Yeah, it is really tough. At some point, it's got to click. You can only watch so much film and go through so many drills until there's carryover into game-time situations.
Well, this team continues to show flashes, and they have a lot of moving parts with young players. They still have a very high ceiling. Here's a drive and a blatant walk. No call, but then a block shot by Buchanan. She got it, got fouled, and a walk the length to shoot two. As that time, Reeves drove into the lane. Walked from here to Schenectady and was not called for the travel somehow, but it worked out for Delaware.
And Kelsey Buchanan, you know, like you said, is an excellent free throw shooter. Shoots over 85%, and that's exactly who you'd want on the line. And with, you know, just over 2 minutes, the Hens look to be in really, really good shape.
So two free throws coming for Buchanan, who has a double-double for the game. 20 points and 10 rebounds already. As she heads to the stripe right here, line left. And her first free throw is good, so she'll get one more. Buchanan scored 27 in the overtime win against Hofstra. That was her career high. She's established a new career high 8 times this season as Buchanan hits the second. That's an incredible number to me. She may have put it out of reach, though, finally with that 27 against Hofstra.
And Kelsey Buchanan, you know, what a great job on the floor. Just, you know, I don't know if anybody really thought that she was going to do what she's done this year and just been a great on-the-floor leader.
She knocked down both free throws, so she's up to 22. If UNC Wilmington keeps fouling, who knows? Atkins, top of the circle, steps into a deep two, rattles it out, Johnson the rebound, and I think the Seahawks will call off the dogs at this point. 1:50 left, and Delaware up 60-44.
Boy, when people look at the scores later tonight or pick up the paper tomorrow and see, you know, right now it's a 16-point lead, we'll have no idea the fight that Delaware was in tonight and how they had to grasp at everything to just kind of extend it a little bit, and then they were able to, you know, slam the door.
Buchanan, head fake, drive, left-hand finish. That's pretty. 24 points for Kelsey Buchanan to go along with 10 rebounds. And it's 62-44 UD.
And with Joy Caracciolo and Jade Clark and Alicia Bell going to the scorer's table, I would be really surprised if Kelsey Buchanan does not come out of the game at the next dead ball.
Deep three, McMillan back-rimmed it. Buchanan another rebound, adding to the stats. Although I don't know if another whistle will blow here. And I think they're going to come over, call the timeout to make the substitution. Just to make sure you don't lose Buchanan. Mm-hmm. She'll go out, as will Johnson, as will Jardine, and a standing ovation for the effort and a well-deserved ovation for Kelsey Buchanan.
Yeah, she's played great. You know, nobody really had a very good game against JMU, but tonight, Akeem Richards now getting, I really like what Tina Martin just did there. She waited and gave Akeem Richards her own ovation because, boy, what a game by Akeem Richards, just all around, assist, points, spark plugs, that confidence, a little bit of mojo out there. Nice to see. She's such a nice kid. Such a nice kid, Akeem Richards.
She really is. 14 points, 4 assists in tonight's game as Brown's pass tip. She gets it back, 48 seconds left, dribbling left wing. High screen from Leone, fires up a jumper and hits, and it's a 20-point lead. Boy, if you had told me at any point in the second half, Delaware would be up, I believe it's a 20-point lead, isn't it? Yes, they finally changed the scoreboard. 64-44, I'd have said no way.
Well, when you think about the JMU game being a 3-point game at halftime and then the way JMU kind of went on a run, things happen fast in basketball.
A nice final 10 minutes from this UD team as UNC Wilmington ran out of steam. McMillan, right wing triple, back rimmed it, rebound and a foul. Over the back on Flowers. Somebody does foul out for this Wilmington team as that is Flowers' fifth. And the Hens will walk the length and a chance to pad the stats. Just two free throws coming and up 20 and on the rocks.
And like you asked earlier, you know, UNCW hanging around, but eventually, you know, when do they wear out? Only suiting up 8 players, only playing up to 7. I'd say about the 8 minute mark left to go, they wore out.
The first free throw, Alicia Bell back rims it. She'll get one more. And how about this? The collegiate debut coming here for Brenna Williams. She was surprised by it, struggling to get the warm-up jacket off. But Brenna Williams, the local product out of Wilmington, Delaware, will check in. Erica Brown replaced. And by the way, if you want to relive this one, you get to see it from the coach's perspective. Hens All Access. Check it out on the next Blue Hens beat. Tina Martin mic'd up. We'll see how she dealt with this young team from their struggles early to their success late as the second free throw good.
And Brenna Williams, a little family reunion down at JMU. Her sister Sarah Williams, who played at Ursuline and then finished her career at JMU collegiately and assistant coach for JMU. They had a little family moment there.
There's a jumper, no good here from Mobley. And she's also on the floor with a former college or high school teammate, Joanna McMillan. But the Hens run out the clock here as they win the game 65-44. Delaware rallying back to get the victory. At one point down 16-5 in the first half. From that point forward, they outscore UNC Wilmington by 32. Not bad from Delaware, which improves to 11-4 on the year at 3-1 in league action.
Saw improvement, like you said, from the beginning of the game to the end. A baby step in, you know, coming back to reality, working on the little things. But that's the way Tina Martin, at least in the second half, wanted her team to respond, and they did.
We will take a break. Still more to come here from the Carpenter Center. We'll hear from our player of the game, plus the head coach of the Fighting Blue Hens, Tina Martin, as Delaware wins it 65-44. You're listening to Blue Hen Basketball on 1290 The Ticket and 1410 WDOV.